The following presentation of City Cinematheque is made possible in part by the cooperation of the Czech Center of New York, the National Film Archives, Prague, the State Fund for Cinematography of the Ministry of Culture of the Czech Republic, and Czech Television.
Welcome to City Cinematheque, where the art and pleasure of the movies are the subject of serious discussion. I'm your host, Jerry Carlson, and I teach film studies at the City College of the City University of New York. Today, it's our pleasure to begin a retrospective of some of the work of one of the most distinguished European filmmakers of the past 25 years, but someone whose works we haven't seen that much of. I'm speaking of the great Czech filmmaker Vera Chytilová. Today we're going to be seeing one of her most famous films, Daisies, from 1966. This is a film that very much comes from the epoch of experimentation in which it was made. It tests the language of films, and it also tests our perceptions of how women should be and can be portrayed on film. It's a wild ride, it's a gleeful ride, it's intellectually dense, and it's exciting. We'll have that and a lot more to talk about today after today's screening, when we have the great pleasure of having Vera Chytilová joining us here on City Cinematheque. Now, enjoy this rare opportunity to see a great European film, the Czech masterpiece, Daisies. Welcome back to City Cinematheque. I hope you've enjoyed this rare opportunity to see on American television one of the great films from Europe of the 1960s, Daisies, directed by Vera Chytilová. It's the first film in what will be a series of her films screened here on City Cinematheque. And to start the series, we have the enormous pleasure of having with us today on City Cinematheque for an interview about this film and her work, Vera Chytilová. Vera, welcome to City Cinematheque. By the way, we will be, in the next 30 minutes or so, conducting a conversation with her. I will be posing my questions in English, and Ms. Chytilová will be responding in Czech. You will hear a voice-over translation of her. So, let's begin. Vera, let us talk first simply about how you came to make Daisies. What were the circumstances of its creation?
Whenever I make any kind of film, my first concern is always with human emotions and human behavior. And in this film, my co-author and I were particularly concerned with the question of destructiveness, the human appetite or impulse to destroy things. Of course, in a certain way, this was directed against the regime of the time, which had in many ways destroyed human lives. It was particularly a response to the question of so-called rehabilitation and the whole concept of rehabilitation, because it seemed to me that a human life cannot really be rehabilitated once it has been destroyed. There is no repair to it. The comedy is obviously an ironic film. It's meant to poke fun at human behavior and human morality. By no sense did we want to make a psychological film as such. Of course, this was precisely how the authorities perceived it, that this was a film about contemporary youth. In fact, it was very much our intention that these characters would behave almost as puppets, in no way with psychological realism. One of the main themes we wanted to develop was how the smallest kind of evil intention or destructive intention can very gradually develop and snowball, as it were, so that it increases to a greater level, even to the level of war. And that ultimately, it's not a question of the size of the act to begin with. If the act in its origin is evil, it can have these consequences. I have to tell you one little story about this. The public perception of this film at times was so inane that one representative in the parliament actually raised his voice and said, "How is it possible that in a time of economic crisis we can show in a Czech film people stomping on the food?"
Tell me about what problems you had with the distribution of this film. Was it easy for this film to be distributed in Czechoslovakia and also abroad?
Originally, the problem was not so much with the distribution, but actually with the screenplay. For a long time, the script itself had been banned. Our colleague, the director of the film company, wanted to save us the trouble of banging us our heads against the wall with this, but we insisted that we would be happy to bang our heads. We were helped very much at this time that Mr. Ponti took an interest in the film, and most of all, Mr. Amos Folger took an interest in the film, who had always had a very avid interest in Czechoslovak film and wanted to include this film for a program of Czechoslovak film in New York. The regime did not want to let the film go at first, but we made it a sine qua non that either we contribute films to the festival and you include Daisies, or we will send no films. And of course, the film was allowed to be shown in 1967.
Did this film, at the time it was released, did it open doors for Vera Chytilová, or did it close doors? What happened to you just after this film was made and released?
At that time, it was a period of liberalization in Czechoslovak politics. So generally, I had freedom to do what I wanted at this point. Of course, I was considered a somewhat suspicious character, and my work was followed very closely. However, it certainly was a great help to have had the exposure in New York, and this attracted attention from abroad, in particular in Belgium, where a producer offered to co-produce a film for me. This was the film We Eat the Fruits of Paradise.
My
very first film was about something different, and this film won the first prize at Mannheim, and this was also a good opportunity for me, and I had the chance to show this film on a tour of film clubs in France. We also showed, along with this tour, Sedmi krásky, the Daisies. This was a time of great interest overall in Czech film. This so-called new generation, this new wave of Czech directors, attracted a lot of attention. I and all of my colleagues from the film school were closely followed with the films we did for graduation and for the premieres of our first professional films after that. I should just explain a little bit the context of how Czechoslovak filmmaking was at this time. There existed about five different creative groups that were working on various projects at once, and they had finances and means to make about four or five films a year. So we were able to produce about 25 films a year overall.
Let me ask something about the style in general of these Czech films, and of course you can comment about your own style, but the official style that was created in the Soviet Union in the 30s, and they tried to impose virtually everywhere, was of course called socialist realism. And one of the features of socialist realism is its utter clarity. Everything is clear, and it's always promoting a certain ideology. One of the great things about the Czech New Wave, but also about your films, is they seem completely opposed to this in every kind of way. Could you talk a little bit about this circumstance?
First, let me say something about Soviet film. Of course, in its content, it was very limited, but actually it came out of the tradition of Eisenstein and other great and innovative filmmakers. So we actually learned a lot about techniques from them. We wanted to emphasize the use of film, that the language of film is different from that of other arts. It's not like theater, it's not like still photography. So we wanted to use the medium of film to its utmost.
The problem, it is question of the evolution of the cinematograph, cinema language. Yes?
Yes.
Mysleli, že rozhodně nejsou nalezeny hranice toho, co všechno se dá vyjádřit. A proto jsem ve svém filmu Sedmi krásky chtěla...
We wanted to always explore the outmost limits of the possibility of the filmic language. Daisies was the first color film that we had made, and I wanted to use color to convey a specific meaning. I think of my films as being very semantic.
We were concerned with having all aspects of the film convey some kind of meaning,
not just the color, but also montage, the rhythm of the film, the way the actors would behave, special effects. All of these things should somehow serve to support the idea of the film. Of course, we were concerned about holding the attention of the audience. There had to be enough there to catch the eye, and of course, there also had to be some sort of action that the audience could follow. That's the most simple line. We wanted to make a film that would develop a stream of consciousness, that would explore a whole range of associations.
That's one of the things that I find so interesting about your work, is apart from its experimentation with the language of cinema, it is both the density of the work, that one wants to come back to it, because there's always, sometimes almost too much for a first viewing of the film. But this is attractive to many viewers. There's a sense of coming back to a certain banquet again. But also, you have a very unusual, and this crosses your films, you switch not only your languages of film, but you switch tone in the film. In most films, I know that American spectators are now used to, you enter one kind of film, you have a relationship, usually psychological, with the characters, and then that remains constant. But this is not typical of your work at all. You have another set of interests. Could you talk about that a little bit for us?
Samozřejmě, že já doufám, že to nechcete říct, že vlastně divák u mých filmech není schopen.
I hope that by that you don't mean to say that the audience can't follow the characters in my films. Of course, that at the same time that I'm developing all these means of communication, there needs to be some sort of a pervading thought and a concept that can be followed. I just want to make sure that in my films, it's as rich an affair as possible, that it becomes a real festival for the mind.
Aby to bylo co nejbohatší, aby to bylo co nejnabitější, aby to bylo skutečné dobrodružství ducha. Adventure of the mind. Yeah.
A good phrase that you've just used, an adventure of the mind. No, I did not mean this in any sense as a criticism of your work. I meant it as a kind of way of describing the difference between the relationship that people have with a certain kind of what they think is normal cinema, an American commercial cinema, and a different kind of relationship the spectator has with your cinema. These are different kinds of relationships, different kinds of pleasures. I'm very interested again in this shift in tones that take place. In a number of your films, there are great comic moments. yet they are juxtaposed with other kinds of moments. For example, in your film The Apple Game, it is a romantic comedy in some ways, and yet we have scenes, very candid scenes, in a hospital. Many other directors do not mix these things together, but you mix them in a very striking and compelling way.
Já to chci míchat takhle. Já to takhle dělám schválně.
Of course, I want to mix those tones and styles. When I make a film, I have to look at things from different angles, and I want the viewer to be forced to look at things from different angles. It's very important that there always be an element of surprise in the film.
A že si dovoluji rušit ten předpoklad, a chci rušit I předpoklad diváka, jak to dopadne. Já myslím, že film musí být taky takový, že musí překvapovat.
The films that followed Daisies immediately also contain all of these surprises you speak about. But then 1968 came. Would you tell us what that meant in the coming years? What happened to you and your career as a consequence of 68? And then when did you get to make another film?
Počátku v roce 68 jsme mysleli, že nás odvezou.
At first we thought that we were all going to be sent to Siberia in 1968, and then we were just happy to be alive. And most of us said we would never collaborate again, we would never cooperate in any way with the regime. But of course things changed, time went on, people grow older, they lose their strength, some of them died. And over time many of us were drawn back into the cinema and wanted to find a new way to express ourselves and to address the situation.
Já jsem nechtěla odejít, protože jsem si myslela, že prostě ten rozhovor s tím divákem, s tím občanem, s námi, se všemi je dále potřeba.
I didn't want to lose that relationship with the audience. I wanted to show that it was possible still to criticize things in some way, that it was still possible to take a voice in opposition.
A myslím si, že jestliže se někdo domnívá, že film nemůže mít vliv na lidi, že se strašně mýlí.
I hope people won't say that film doesn't have an effect on people. I believe I know it has an effect on people and that it can support them. I have spoken to people who said that they've seen a film and it's given them strength.
In the sense, in the direction of the moral, yes? Jo, že to má morální vliv.
It has a moral effect on people.
I've had the pleasure of seeing, of course, the first film you made after the catastrophe of 68, The Apple Game. Now the authorities, I'm told, ask you to make a more conservative and realistic film. But in fact, today, when we watch this film, 20 years later, it very much looks like a Chytilová film. And in the context of very conservative commercial filmmaking, it still looks very, very strong. Where did you know when you made The Apple Game? In what ways did you know you were resisting the imposed style and the imposed ideology?
Já jsem nikdy nechtěla dělat jaksi rebela pro
rebela nebo rebel without a cause or just do experiment for the sake of experiment. I think that everything that you explore in film should serve to somehow further express to convey the meaning that you want to have there.
Se cítím a myslím si, že každý tvůrce musí být tak svobodný.
We made We Eat the Fruits of Paradise, which of course was another unconventional exploration, although in a slightly different way than Daisies. After that, it was much later that I had the opportunity to do other work under the condition that it somehow be more realistic. So I don't understand what doesn't seem realistic to you in that film.
If we're talking about the Apple Game, well, first of all, your use of space in the film. Yes, we know we're realistically in a hospital, but there are times in which you distort space, there are times in which you change these tones, so we must, as you wish, so we must keep re-judging the characters, And there's the way in which the film also becomes a non-realistic allegory of the entire society, making comment upon the society. If I had been your censor, I wouldn't have let you make this film, because I would have seen the allegory in the film. I think you were very lucky to have some very stupid censors, so you could make a very fine film.
No, they did try to stop it, yes.
Say it again in Czech.
Jo, oni se o to pokusili to stopnout, ovšem ze žárlivosti.
Of course they tried to stop it. Many people, I think, were jealous when this film came out because there was enormous interest behind it, and people who saw it draw other of their friends to come in and see it. My colleagues, who are also functionaries in the party, tried to protest this film on the grounds that it was pornographic.
Samozřejmě, že málo kdo v té době viděl třeba skutečné porody a tak dále.
I think at the time that this film was made, actually probably not that many men had seen what it was like during birth. And I think what they objected to most was the blood. I said, well, look, in the scenes where you see them cleaning up blood on the floor or whatever, that wasn't real blood, that was fake blood. And they said, oh, but when we see it in your film, we believe that it's real blood. And I said, well, that's strange. You show in war films, you see people bleeding and you see dead people. I wanted to show in this film, at birth, that blood can also be a sign of life as well as a sign of death.
In what ways has the fact that you are the first woman to graduate from the Prague Film Academy, you are the first feature filmmaker in Czechoslovakia who is a woman, in what ways has that caused difficulties for you, or in what ways has it given you other strategies?
Nebyli, já jsem nikdy nepřemýšlela, jestli jsem muž nebo žena, já jsem si toho nevšímala.
I never really thought about it, whether I was a man or a woman. I really didn't pay much attention to that issue.
Prostě mně šlo o to, abych se realizovala. Chtěla jsem se realizovat tak, že jsem chtěla.
I was concerned with realizing my goals. I wanted to find out why things were the way they were.
And did you encounter any problems because you were a woman, or has this not been one of the issues, not been one of the problems? Ideology has been more of a problem, or style has been more of a problem?
No, in the school, ve škole. Ve škole jsem neměla problémy, protože studenti jsou si všichni rovní.
Well, when I was a student, there was a great sense of equality among us. We were all students. And in fact, this was actually one of the things that the ideology supported, was the idea that everyone should have a chance. Before film, I had actually studied architecture, and it was the same case there. So for me, it wasn't a question of whether or not I was a woman, but whether or not I had the talent.
Takže tam byl ten problém, jestli ten talent vůbec mám.
You've now made a number of films since 68. You've made several films after the Apple game, and you've made some work since the change in government. Could you talk to us a little bit now about what has changed in Czech filmmaking? I mean, where are we today? Where is Czech filmmaking today?
Today. Dnes to je dezastr. Dnes musím říct, že
now it's a disaster. Everything has changed. The main thing that we don't know how to do, which you know how to do here, is to find funding to make films. We would feel like beggars going about this. It's the most important work is being just submerged in that creative work. It used to be that we had to deal a bit with the struggle with ideology, but we knew how to do that. Now, what we have to do is defend our work before it's even been created in order to get funding for it.
Tell me a little bit about what you are planning. I mean, what projects does Vera Chytilová have? Now, are you trying to make one film or several films? What are you doing?
Mám asi 4 scénáře a jaksi mám smůlu.
Right now I actually have 4 screenplays that I would like to do, but what always happens is I get one project and I find that it can't be realized and so I start another. But I keep in mind all the time that I would like to finish all of these projects. The oldest of these projects is a historical film about the 19th century Czech woman writer Božena Němcová. It's called The Face of Hope. I wanted to show in this film how someone who was extremely talented, had many diverse different talents, but that because she chose to insist on her beliefs, she had no choice but to die of hunger. The other three projects are contemporary. One of them, for which I've already received partial funding, is a story about a woman who has been raped and then actually castrates the men who raped her. I'd actually like to make out of this film a comedy in which I show how these three people can go on living. Another of these projects is a film which is called Expulsion from Paradise.
Je to z nuda pláže, jo? Řekl jste to?
Co to je?
Nuda pláž. Pláž, kde se jsou nazí.
Aha, it's about a nudist beach. The other project is a film called The Prague Jerusalem Connection, and it's about a young Jewish woman who meets a Christian man and about how those different religious views come in contact and conflict with each other. And this is a film in which I'd like to address the question of fanaticism.
How important is it for you to continue working in Czech and in the Czech Republic? Because one of the problems faced by many countries with very fine film industries is they are small countries. You are now a politician too. You serve, I have a political career. How important is it for you to protect this culture from which you come?
Nejde mi o to, abych dělala národní film, jaksi nacionální ve smyslu nacionální.
I'm not concerned with making a national film in the sense of a nationalistic film. What's important to me is a certain question of spontaneity, of course, and also maintaining the contact with my own audience and to give witness to the culture and the people that I know. Although, of course, there are always tendencies towards generalization that can be drawn from these specifically Czech experiences. It's really, when you think about it, any work of art is at least partially a question of the search for your origins, even though at the same time it is a small world.
Well, I want to thank you, Vera, for joining us here. I think this is an appropriate moment in which we should encourage our spectators to continue following your search for origins through your films in the weeks that are going to come up, that we're going to be showing another set of your films. If you would like more information about City Cinematheque and about this series, please drop us a line. Drop it to City Cinematheque, City University Television, 25 West 43rd Street, Suite 1220, New York, New York, 10036. Let me give you that information again. Drop it to City Cinematheque, City University Television, 25 West 43rd Street, Suite 1220, New York, New York, 10036. Vera, I want to emphasize again what a special and extraordinary occasion it has been for us to hear you talk about a great film industry and to talk about your search for origins in cinema. You will always be welcome to return to City Cinematheque.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
And we hope that you will join us again in the coming weeks on City Cinematheque as we explore the films of Vera Chytilová. Thanks for joining us today.
The preceding presentation of City Cinematheque was made possible in part by the cooperation of the Czech Center of New York, the National Film Archives, Prague, the State Fund for Cinematography of the Ministry of Culture of the Czech Republic, and Czech Television.